Peter Rizun, Dr. Peter Rizun, pleasure to have you with us at SF Cryptocurrency Devs. Thank you for coming out tonight.
It's great to be here.
Awesome. So we wanted to do a nice one-on-one just to get a little intimate about, you know, your background in Bitcoin. Specifically, what got you into Bitcoin? How did you become, you know, essentially a, you know, developer and a professional? What was your process? You spoke about that tonight.
Yeah, so I guess there's two questions there: how I got interested in Bitcoin, and then how I moved into development.
Yep.
So, how I got into Bitcoin was I just kept hearing about it. So I heard about Bitcoin for the first time in 2010, actually by my mother of all people, and she had read this article. I guess it was a Slashdot article that would have been around at the right time. And she's like, "Peter, have you heard about this new currency called Bitcoin?" And she's like, "And apparently we can buy some if we mail this money off to so and so." And she wanted to buy like $100 worth, and she wanted me to help her. And I'm like, "Mom, that's so stupid. Like, it's probably just total crap technology. Get some rip off." I didn't even read the article. And looking back, like, that would have been like $100 million right now.
Right. Right. So,
yeah. So I kind of kicked myself for that. But anyways, I would slowly hear more and more about Bitcoin, but I kept, you know, not taking it seriously. I would, you know, eventually see those pictures of those coins, and I'm like, this is just play money. It wasn't until March of 2013, I was driving in my car, and I heard on the radio that Bitcoin hit a new all-time high of $40.
Right, wow.
And the reporter said that this was due to the bank account confiscations in the Mediterranean island nation of Cyprus.
Right, okay.
And it's like weird, like I can't believe there's this correlation between like what's happening in the real economy and this what I thought was play money.
Right.
And I remembered, you know, hearing a couple years ago that Bitcoin had parity with the US dollar. So I'm like, okay, if Bitcoin is still around after, you know, I think it was 3 years at that point in time, and its value keeps increasing, you know, maybe there's something to it. So right. I went home and I decided to, you know, research and read all I could about Bitcoin, and I came across the Satoshi white paper.
There you go.
And I have a technical background, and I'm kind of a hobbyist, like an armchair economist, I'll say, as well. So I was interested in the math, interested in the science, interested in the money aspect. And when I read the paper, I was just like, wow, like, this changes everything. This is like a solution, a way to make something digital behave like something physical with scarcity.
Right.
And so it made so much sense to me right away that I just kind of fell in love with the concept, and I've been hooked ever since.
Nice. And so now, what are you doing today in Bitcoin?
So there was kind of a long process between, you know, me getting interested in Bitcoin as a concept and me becoming active in development.
Right.
And I, you know, spoke about that.
That's right.
Earlier today. So right now we're at another exciting time in Bitcoin's life cycle, because for the last 2 or 3 years there was the great scaling debate of, you know, 2014 to 2017.
That's right.
And Bitcoin basically broke out into these two warring factions, the small blockers on the one side, and the big blockers on the other side. So I come from the big blocker faction,
okay.
And we've been working hard for the last...
What is the big blocker color?
The big blocker color is green.
Green.
The color that money should be.
That's right.
So the war kind of came to an end in August 1st of 2017, where the blockchain split into two chains, the BTC chain and the BCH chain, and now we can finally do what we want on the BCH chain and continue allowing this Bitcoin experiment to play out the way that Satoshi Nakamoto designed it to play out.
Right, right. So which one would you call real Bitcoin?
It's a really difficult question to answer.
But he's going to answer.
So I think they're both Bitcoin.
Okay.
I think it's fair to say that BTC and BCH are both branches of what originally was Bitcoin.
Okay, that's a great answer.
I got a bit more to that, though.
Okay.
So in terms of the chain, this most like what Bitcoin was designed to be like, this most like what Satoshi wrote about in the white paper, that most meets a description of a peer-to-peer electronic cash system, something with, you know, low fees, fast transactions, reliable confirmation.
Mm-hmm.
In every way like that, Bitcoin Cash is more Bitcoin-like than BTC.
Okay.
However, one objective measure of a blockchain's value is how much proof of work has been added to the chain.
Right.
BTC has more total work in it than BCH.
There you go.
And I think largely because BTC kept the ticker, so I think just by based on momentum, a lot of people just thought that Bitcoin Cash is some altcoin.
Right.
And I think a lot of the miners stayed on the BTC chain. But, you know, I can make excuses, but by that metric, BTC is more Bitcoin than Bitcoin Cash.
Okay. If I'm an engineer, not in Bitcoin, and not in the blockchain, but wanting to get involved and sort of explore and develop, what would your advice be to be like, here's how you can start being a developer in Bitcoin?
I think it depends where you are in, you know, in your knowledge. Like the first step is just to read. You know, there's so much great resources out there if you search for it. Mm-hmm. Look for work by Satoshi Nakamoto, who obviously got this whole experiment started. Gavin Andreessen, Greg Maxwell, Mike Hearn, just to name a couple of
some
names.
Small blockers in there.
Yeah, there's some small blockers, but they made some valuable technical contribution as well. And then once you've read enough, then you know, start getting your hands dirty and start making stuff.
Right.
So, in order to take your understanding to that next level, you really need to get your hands dirty and start playing with the protocol at the software and the hardware level. Then I think you want to be like publishing quality content that you can share with the community.
Sure.
And that's important for, you know, receiving that critical feedback that'll help you grow as a developer.
Yep.
It, very importantly, it allows you to network with new people that will give you new ideas or maybe job opportunities or introduce you to cool, new, exciting projects you didn't think about. And it helps you sort of build your brand as a developer, your own personal brand. And it sounds kind of weird saying that, like if you come from the regular side of tech, because you know, a lot of stuff happens in companies. You don't really have to worry about your brand and the bigger context of the whole Twitter sphere or something.
Right.
But Bitcoin, so much development and politics happens in the public sphere that I think it's of value to developers to build some sort of a brand for themselves in social media.
And they can stand on that. All right, so final question. 10 years, it's now 2028.
Mm-hmm.
What does the Bitcoin world look like from your view?
I don't know. Obviously, I don't know.
Right, right.
I'll tell you what I hope happens.
Okay.
What I hope happens is that the Bitcoin experiment proves to be successful. And what that will look like is we move forward with Satoshi's original design, and that's allowing Bitcoin to continue to grow with bigger and bigger blocks. Users can verify their own transactions, be their own banks, and send payments to any other user in the world. So we're still satisfying the original design goals of Bitcoin using SPV technology that already exists.
So SPV is
simplified payment verification.
Okay.
Satoshi wrote about it in the Bitcoin white paper. Bread wallet, available for iOS as an example of an SPV wallet. Mm-hmm. So I see that technology becoming ubiquitous if Bitcoin takes off. And everyone will have Bitcoin wallets on their phones,
right.
And it'll be a Bitcoin universe.
Got it. And which chain will have the most work at that point?
Bitcoin Cash, of course.
Right.
And people will just call it Bitcoin at that point.
People will just call it Bitcoin.
Yes.
Thank you so very much, Peter.
Thanks.
All right, have a pleasure having you with us. Thank you.